गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन मॉड्यूल 2 ऑफ लेसन नंबर 3 वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन। द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन सिस्टम इज लोकेटेड इन द पेल्विक रीजन। इट इज मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स इन कंपैरिजन टू द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एंड इट इज डीपली सिचुएटेड। इट इंक्लूड्स ए पेयर ऑफ ओवरीज, ए पेयर ऑफ ओविडक्ट, यूटेरस, सर्विक्स, vagina and external genitalia. Here oviducts, uterus and vagina, they act as accessory ducts. A pair of the mammary glands also present in female, or these are also considered as the part of female reproductive organ because they are responsible for the nourishing of developing offsprings. All parts are integrated structurally and functionally, means they are joined with one to another to support the process of ovulation, to release out the egg, fertilization, fusion of gamete, and to maintain pregnancy, birth, and the child care. These are the functions which is carried by female reproductive organs. Here we are going to show you the sectional view through pelvis, how these particular organs in females, they are situated within the body of female organism. Now female gonads, ovaries. Gonads, because these ovaries, they are the organ which is responsible to produce female gamete, ovum, as well as they are going to release out two steroid hormones, androgen and progesterone. These are located in lower abdomen. Each ovary is about 2 to 4 cm in length. These are connected to the pelvic wall and uterus by ligament. So ligament, they are responsible to attach these ovaries in pelvic region. Each ovary is covered by the epithelium which encloses ovarian stoma. Ovarian stoma has two zones, one is peripheral cortex and inner medulla. At the periphery, peripheral means located at the outside boundaries, cortex follicles are present, and in middle, blood vessels and ovarian ligaments are present. These are the arrangement. Here cervix, corneal canal and vagina, they are responsible to form the birth canal. Ovary, they are attached outside this organ with the help of ligament. They are joined, opens into a funnel like structure which contains finger like projections with them, which is called fimbri. Below the fimbri there is a broad structure that is called infundibulum, opens into ampulla and isthmus. These ampulla and isthmus, they are the part where the process of fertilization will take place. A inverted pear-shaped structure, broad structure that is called uterus, covered by three lining, perimetrium and myometrium and endometrium. Perimetrium, that is going to provide the outer covering. Endometrium undergoes cyclic change during menstrual cycle, while the myometrium exhibits strong contraction during the delivery of the baby. While the accessory duct, oviduct and fallopian tube, that 10 to 12 cm in length, form periphery of each ovary to uterus. Parts, we have already discussed the infundibulum, as is finger-like projection, fimbri, and ampulla isthmus junction. These are the main part of female reproductive organs, and all these parts, gonads along with accessory ducts and gland, constitute the female reproductive organs.